one of the saddest stories I've seen come through here. This is Andrew. He is relatively new to us. His story is that he was found by a kind soul that decided to pick him up and bring him in when she noticed that this dog was curled up, laying next to his friend that did not make it. They were both bait dogs in some situation. We have had a vet confirm that his teeth have been filed down for the purpose of, you know, the bait dog thing. As you can see, his legs here, they've got a lot of bad scarring, and they're kind of misshapen a little bit. They have been severely injured, most likely broken and not healed properly. So he does kind of have like a funny walk to him, because he's just sustained so much injury over the past, and it's not been obviously taken care of at all. He's got pretty bad teeth because, like I said, they were filed down. He's gonna need some dental work to help him with that. So he's actually on a diet of wet food only because of that. He's got some scarring on the face. He's missing a little bit of this ear. He's just all beat up and messy. But
through, look at him.
Through,
I mean,
all of
yes,
this,
look at
he
this.
Is the most loving, happy, just true, meaningful, you know, second chance dog that I've ever seen. He's just, you wouldn't know without looking at him, just knowing his personality, you'd have no idea that this dog has been through what he's been through.
He's so sweet.
Yeah, and so sweet, loves affection. He really just wants to be with people. He'll do whatever he can to get to you and love on you. And also, which is even more impressive to me, he's dog friendly. He does get a little scared of big dogs, understandably, because he's probably been attacked several times. But he's not aggressive whatsoever. He's very willing to meet new dogs. As long as they're nice to him and they're not overbearing, he's totally fine with them. He loves everybody he meets. He's learned now to walk on a leash. He didn't like that at first, but he learned pretty quickly. He's a great dog. He's ready for his normal dog life to start.
And we think he's about 8 to 10 years old,
around,
I think,
8
right?
to 10, but yeah. It's really hard because we judge that by the teeth,
by the
and
teeth.
He has no teeth.
Yeah, yeah, so. Yeah. I tell you, as active as he is, he seems like a, you know, especially with what he's been through.
Yeah.
I wouldn't guess he's that old myself.
I don't think he's much older than that, if at all. No. Yeah. I think he's just in really bad shape.
Yeah, the poor
fella. He's maybe not going to, you know, have the longest life of any dog because he's had such a rough past, but he's certainly healthy for his standards right now. And getting healthier every day. And he's the best thing is that he's mentally happy and healthy there. So he's just ready. He's ready for his new life to be the opposite of what he's been through.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Ready to love somebody or everybody.
If ever somebody deserved a better life than they've had.
Oh, yeah.
It's got to be this guy.
Yep, we're ready to give him a good second chance here.
So he needs a long-term foster home,
yes,
doesn't he?
Yes, so the other thing about him is that he did test positive for heartworms, and our vet felt it was best. He does not have the best immune system, so he's not a candidate for the normal heartworm treatment. It's pretty heavy-duty, and it can take a heavy toll on them, so we're not going to put him through that. We're going to do what's called a slow kill, and so he will need a kind of a long-term foster with hopefully being an adopter afterwards, but he is foster only right now until we can get the heartworms taken care of. We are going to treat him. It's just not going to be as quick as our normal treatment. So he does need a foster home, and that'll kind of just help him learn how to be a dog as well, someone's pet, you know.
Yeah.
So if you're interested in fostering him, we can talk more. You call us or come in and meet him, and we can talk more about the specifics with that because it's kind of an unknown time factor. But we are going to treat him and get him to where he's 100% healthy, and at that point, then he will be adoptable.
What a sweetheart.
Oh, yeah.
I tell you what, you want to do a great thing for a dog who just so deserves it. We hope you'll give us a call or come on over and meet Andrew.